Hello and welcome all to the Pro Gymnastics Cup Series. We're here in the beautiful Pocono Mountains at the famed International Gymnastics Camp, also known as IGC. And tonight, IGC is transformed.
So prepare for the skill-for-skill battle between some of the most talented past, present, and future gymnasts and acromaniacs out there. We have an intense in-arena audience cheering on the Olympians, world champs, and all-star NCAA athletes tonight. And there's just a ton of excitement packed in a very short period of time. This is a chance to see athletes go bigger than ever before. And it's a pleasure to be with you. I'm Stephen Douglas, former NCAA gymnast from William & Mary and head coach at MIT Gymnastics.
And I'm Ashley Lee, former NCAA LSU gymnast.
And also a two-time All-American.
Thank you, Steve. This is a live webcast at the Pro Gymnastics Challenge Cup being streamed on professionalgymnastics.com. All fans should reach out to athletes and post, tweet, and Insta-G at Pro Gymnastics and trend hashtag ProGymCup to get inside scoops and chat with other PGC athletes during the competition.
Awesome. Now, I want to give a little background on the Professional Gymnastics Challenge and the Cup Series in particular. The Professional Gymnastics Challenge Cup is a summer series, and last June, many of these athletes went head-to-head in a nationally televised competition. Now, athletes are competing in both teams and individuals. Winners of the individual competition are in contention for an invitation to the PGC Arena event. And tonight, why don't you tell us a little about tonight's newcomers?
Tonight we have the 2014 NCAA champion, Kat Grable from Arkansas, Don L. Wittenberg, the U.S. Olympic Training Center, Luisa Galolina, a 2008 Uzbeka Olympian team member.
Awesome. And tonight's competition is brought to us by a couple key sponsors. One is a Professional Gymnastics Challenge, and we're going to take it right over to the rope climb. It looks like they're getting started, so let's check it out on the rope climb. Here we go. And athletes will be competing now for the control. We have two teams here.
This will determine who starts on the first event.
All right.
Oksana's got the lead.
There we go.
They are racing up that rope.
And there we go with Jake Dalton in the blue shorts there.
Chris is trying to close the gap.
All right, and who's up? Donnell in the blue shorts. That's Donnell Wittenberg.
It is a race.
There we go. Brandon Wynn.
Oh.
All right.
Donnell was able to bring it home.
And so it looks like your team IGC gets the win. IGC is going to be in the blue tonight. And competitive nature, the other team will be in red.
That's right. So tonight, Team IGC will choose whether they want to start.
And that's right. All right, so we're checking out now. Athletes are going to get ready for their first event. First event is going to be on the rings.
It is loud in here tonight.
It absolutely is, and the energy. So let's go through the teams here. For Team IGC, we have Donnell Wittenberg. We have Jake Dalton, 2012 Olympian. We have Oksana Shutnovitna, six-time Olympian, and Alina Weinstein, from the University of Illinois and also the 2014 coach at Nebraska.
Yes, and tonight on Team Competitive Nature, we have Brandon Wynn, a 2012 Olympic competitor, also a PGC athlete in 2013. We have Chris Brooks, who just missed PGC last year because of a broken thumb. Catherine Cat Grable, who is a two-time national champion in 2014. And Luisa Galolina, who is a 2008 Olympic competitor for Pakistan.
All right, so those are our teams. We have Team IGC and Team Competitive Nature.
And like we said, Team Competitive Nature will be in the red tonight. And
all right, and for our judges here, we have a stacked judging panel here. You check it out, we have Ivan Ivankov, who is a world champion, three golds, three silver, five bronzes, and also the assistant coach at University of Illinois. We have A.B. Grossfeld, who is the classic Hall of Famer gymnast, five-time Olympian coach, and also the only gold medal winning coach of the 1984 Olympics. And then Fred Orlovsky, who's a 1960 Olympian. And that's who's going to be judging all the athletes' skills tonight and giving favor to whoever executes the highest, best, and biggest skills.
That's right. So tonight it won't be like a general gymnastics format. Things are a little different, and there's three rounds.
So here we go. The crowd is going wild for Danelle Wittenberg. Danelle is an animal on rings. He is a true competitor over at the OTC, the Olympic Training Center. He's going to get on the rings. His sequence is going to be... Here we go.
First, an Azarian cross pull to Maltese.
Here we go. Excellent execution to Maltese, and he's trying to get that as flat as he can and hold it. Into cross. And there he is. Danelle Wittenberg, Team IGC.
The crowd certainly seems to love it.
All right. Now we have Brandon hashtag winning. As Brandon gets ready, we have the replay here. Check it out. Now you're looking for the hold. You're looking for that from hand to hand flatness. And he's supposed to be parallel with the ground here. That bounce and boom, right back into the iron cross.
I would say it was pretty close to perfect.
And he knows it too. But this is not easy. This is definitely not easy, because actually Danelle is number two in the country on rings. Right now we have the only man ahead of him, and that is Brandon Wynn.
So he will be up next on the rings doing the exact same skill. And they'll go head to head, and the judge will basically determine who they liked better.
Here we go. And he's being helped out there by Chris Brooks, also fellow 2012 Olympian. And look at his wingspan. Right down in the cross, and you can count it out. Give a little head flick to the crowd. Acknowledge them. Look around.
Like that.
That's afternoon tea up there, friends.
Oh, this
he
is
knows
it. Form.
He knows it. Team competitive nature. Doing a great job up there with a little show off.
It was pretty neck and neck between the two of them, number one and two.
All right, now we're gonna catch a replay. We're gonna go right to the judges, it looks like. They're ready to make a decision.
So at this point, the judges will just decide whose was better, technically, just whatever they liked about it best.
They're looking for hold, they're looking for execution of skill, they're looking for cleanness, they're looking for a little showmanship.
Which is tough because, Steven, they were both clean, they were both great, they were both awesome. So it's gonna be really tough for these judges to make an ultimate decision.
But we know it. If there are any judges that can make the decision, it's going to be them. AB tends to err on the side of a little conservative, but we haven't really seen Fred Orlovsky, where he's going to lean here.
So we've come to a conclusion.
Ivan Ivankov, he's going to give it to team.
Competitive nature with the win. That'll be a point for competitive nature. Next, we'll go to the single rail. And this is where the ladies will perform, again, the same skill, and they'll be doing a Kominichi. We'll start from Team IGC. Alina, we'll start with a Kominichi.
And this is Alina Weinstein, competed for University of Illinois. She's also the 2014 coach for University of Nebraska women's team.
It was the first time they made it to Super 6, which is a huge accomplishment.
Awesome. And you'll check out, she's rocking the X bands on her grips to keep
she
her
goes.
Grips in place. And boom!
Very nice. Very nice.
She really can show it off. Alina really.
She seemed to like it. The crowd seemed to like it. It was really, really good. She released exactly when she needed to release, enabling her to catch the bar.
And she loves to show it off.
The Kominichi is kind of an inward flip, more of a blind skill, so it's not an easy thing to do.
She went right for it. And we have the judges now deliberating. We're going to turn right to the replay.
You can see in the replay exactly when she releases. Good cast. Right into the wow. coming each. She loved it. She loved it.
And she wants that crowd engaged. She wants everybody loud.
She wants that crowd, and she wants that point.
And we remember Alina from the 2013 PGC.
That's right.
Challenge.
Superstar.
Exactly. She really came through on bars, actually. This was her event, her come-through event.
So next up, we'll have Catherine Grable. And again, she'll do a come and each. Same skill. Just you can do it better. She seems really focused. You know, it's crazy because these girls don't compete these skills. It's kind of fun for them because they get to learn it and kind of just go out there and have fun with it.
Here we go.
Huge release move.
And she caught it. And she's
awesome.
Got great job. And what you're noticing, for all you gymnastics purists out there, that this is not their traditional uneven bar setup. What we have are women competing on the single rail and with pads as well. So
it really allows them to do bigger skills, take a little more risk, throw those big skills, and that, honestly, was a big release move. Lots of height, and, they both caught it.
All right. Now, as judges deliberate here, we can see the men lining up for the high bar.
We're going to watch the replay here with Catherine Grable's Komenich. Good start. Really nice. Kind of hit her heel a little bit on that mat, but did what she needed to do.
And this is Kat's first competition. She's looking for an invite. She's looking for an invite to the arena challenge, the professional gymnastics challenge in the arena.
Right.
Got the crowd hyping up the men going to high bar.
Yeah, so this event really does, it's kind of a competition too to see who is going to compete in the big PGC event.
That's right.
So there's a lot at stake here. It is fun for them and they enjoy it, but you know, there is some there's some reward at the end of it.
It's on the line, and athletes came from around the world at the last 2013 Professional Gymnastics Challenge. And this is the Cup Series.
Yep, and it looks like competitive nature again with the point. So that'll be 2 points for competitive nature. IGC still struggling to get on the board, but hey, it's still early.
Early in the competition. We are in the last event for the first round. We're going to have 3 rounds in total here.
3 events, 3 rounds, 2 competitors head-to-head.
And here we go. You know him well. This is Jake Dalton, 2012 Olympian.
Working for another one.
That's right. Training for 2016. Here he goes.
Let's start.
Want to change? He's doing a double dismount here. Watch this positioning. Laid out two back. Two twists.
Very nice.
There aren't many people that can do it better than that.
No. It's truly incredible the height that these athletes get coming off the apparatus.
Such power by Jake Dalton. But
control, like throwing these big skills and you're controlling them and they're clean.
Absolutely, and not only that, speaking of power, you're going to notice another gentleman about to mount the high bar here. This is Chris Brooks. Now Chris doesn't mess around on high bar. He goes big. He never goes home.
No, doesn't mess around on high bar, but he seems to be a little bit of a jokester.
He's definitely a showman, and here we go. Jake Dalton, check it out again. That's 2 backflips, 2 twists, count them out. Follow that, that's happening pretty quickly. Now, another point for the gymnastics purists here, where you're going to see some points of differentiation. The athletes don't necessarily need to stick the landings. This is really about the show. And speaking of show, here is Chris Brooks. Check out his wingspan. Here he goes.
So you say it's not about the landing. So what are the judges looking for?
They're going to look for height. They're going to look for speed and momentum. They're going to look for the rotation. They're going to look for the tap.
Wow.
That's what we call afternoon tea. He was up there. He was basically putting calls in. He was probably sending tweets up there.
It took him a little while to come down. That was awesome.
Stalled that out. We'll see what the judges have to say. Hopefully we'll get a replay in.
this is great because you can see, you know, Jake just did an awesome dismount, Chris just did an awesome dismount, and it's, they're over there smiling, laughing with one another, they're having fun. You know, there's a competitive edge, but
they're having fun. And if you're sitting there in front of your laptop, try to count out those twists and flips. Count it out loud for us. We want to hear you in the Pocono Mountains.
And the judges gave it to competitive nature once again.
Wow. Wow.
That's 3 points for competitive nature.
That's a clean sweep right there.
That's competitive nature, round one.
And we're going to be moving down.
Gave him the score to competitive nature. We're going to go ahead and go to a commercial break. We'll be right back with PGC.
Here we go.
The last PGC was awesome for me. I didn't really know what to expect because we had never done one. Everybody is pretty competitive, so you know, your nerves start going and someone starts doing some skills that maybe you can't do or you've never done, and you want to try them just because, you know, you guys are all so competitive. We tried skills maybe that we hadn't done before or we hadn't done in a long time. You know, I was thinking before that, I was like, I wouldn't necessarily try something too crazy. And as soon as the competition started rolling, I was like, all right, it's all out. You know, whatever we have to do to try and win, you know, I'll do it. So I think it made it a little more exciting and a little more enjoyable for the crowd and the audience. Brooks is a loud competitor, I would say. He's always the loud guy, you know, he's always either cheering or laughing or joking or just having fun. So he's a lot of fun to compete with, but he's also very competitive. He's a very talented guy as well. So it's gonna make for a good competition. It should be fun, it should be a little rowdy. Brooks is good on high bar, but I think I'll be able to give him a run for his money. Having a wife, you know, it's great. It has its advantages and disadvantages. When I go home, it's nice to relax with somebody and just kind of explain how your day went. It's definitely, it's different than just being single and training, you know, when you can commit everything to that. But she's actually been good for my training with, you know, eating schedules and just eating habits and everything like that. So it's been good for me.
Floor with the athletes doing some interviews. Jake Dalton there. We're getting ready for round two now.
All right, guys, I'm here with Jake Dalton. So, Jake, how do you think the first round of competition went?
Went pretty good. I thought we started out, you know, pretty good on rings. I thought we had a chance. They gave it to them. On bars, I really thought it was us. They gave it to them. Did my best on the high bar, but it wasn't good enough, so we'll have to come back in the second round.
Yeah, what are you looking forward to in the second round?
A little more skills on a high bar. It's a little more fun for me and some more big gymnastics for my team.
That's great. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Fantastic. All right, it's always nice to get the athlete's perspective on the floor there. They look like they're having fun getting ready for round two. And again, round two is going to happen fast. We're going rings, single rail with the women, and then back to high bar for men in round two. The sequence on rings, it's going to be extraordinarily complicated. It's going to be a back uprise to Maltese, Azarian, back to Maltese. And we'll call it out, we'll describe it a little bit so you know exactly what you're looking at for all you non-gymnasts out there.
And you being a gymnast, explain how difficult the rings really are. I mean, it's not getting up there and just... Yeah. So, in the rings, I mean... How difficult is this, the Azarian Maltese?
Well, let me tell you, these guys are going to make it look pretty easy. And Danelle Wittenberg up on rings, you're going to see this. He's going back uprise, Maltese. Here's the back uprise of Maltese. All right. His feet are a little bit low there. He's going all the way up. And he's holding up there. And again, Danelle is one of the younger guys. He's 19 years old. He's at the USOTC now. He's getting the crowd pumped. But you know what? He's up against number one, and you have to bring your best here with Brandon Wynn in the mix.
That's right. Number one and two, back to back.
That's right. You're watching it here at the Pro Cup.
You guys can see at home. That is nothing easy. It takes serious focus, strength.
Now make sure anybody with any questions, you're also on professionalgymnastics.com, and you can be asking some of the athletes who competed in last year. We have a handful of them. All right, Brandon Wynn is getting ready to rock.
Brandon Wynn doing the same skill.
2012 Olympian. And Brandon Wynn, he's just here to have fun. He's here to push himself. He's here to do big skills. Here he goes, getting ready for the back uprise. And he should be perfectly flat here. And he's looking.
Flat.
Someone better check his pulse, because he's pretty flatlined there. Look at that.
Very nice.
He knows it. He knows it.
Very nice.
And again, wearing red, you have the competitive nature, team competitive nature, and blue team IGC. You just have not been able to put anything on the board.
No, not yet, but you know, Stephen, it is still early. There's still time, and they've got a lot of fire and a lot of fight left.
They absolutely do, and you can follow these guys. Danelle Wittenberg, here's the replay here. Danelle Wittenberg at Danelle underscore Wittenberg. And we all know here, Brandon Wynn at Brandon Wynn Gym. He likes to keep an active post stream. Here's the replay. Now look, you should be able to draw a line right across his body, parallel with the ground. Now you can't buy those muscles on eBay.
Very well done.
That's hard training right there.
Judges giving the score again to competitive nature. They are on a roll.
Wow.
They're on fire. That's one thing about these athletes, though, is their competitive edge, their competitive nature. So this will probably light a fire, and I can't wait to see what IGC is going to do.
Here we go, and we're moving right on to the single rail with the women.
We're going to start with Team IGC with Oksana. She will be doing a Tkachev, which is another release move, and it's you're basically flipping over the bar, a blind flip over the bar, and attempting to catch it on the other side.
Now watch the tap here, because it's all in the tap leading into the release move. And you made a point earlier, Ashley, about her grips.
Yeah, Oksana does not use grips, and that may not seem like a big deal, but it really is, and it's a lot of wear on her hands, and that was incredible.
Beautiful.
Very well done. Not only was it incredible, but Oksana is 49 years old, and she just makes it look so easy.
And she's getting ready again for her. She's looking at 7 Olympics. So Oksana actually was doing some of these skills before her competitors were even born.
Right. So next up we're going to watch the replay, and you'll see Oksana start perfectly in a handstand. She taps right where she needs to and just catches the bar with huge amplitude and does exactly what she needs to do.
Second nature for Oksana and Team IGC. Great showing.
So next we're going to have for Team Competitive Nature, Catherine. Oh no, excuse me, Luisa. Luisa is going to be going up next doing the same skill.
And the last name, it's a little tricky. It's Galulina.
She was a 2008 Olympic member for Pakistan. Here she goes.
That's Uzbekistan.
Very nice.
So she is
loves
now,
it.
She is now training Team Uzbekistan, 2008 competitor. And she might be a little bit smaller than the rest of the athletes, but she packs a punch.
That's right. She is little, but that release move was big. Very well done. This is tough for the judges because both of them really do exactly what they need to do. Technically, it's very nice. It's clean.
Smooth. Very smooth. All right. And the judges.
The judges give it to IGC for their first point up on the board. I told you they were going to come through.
All right. Well, Oksana really, really holding herself here. And while we're waiting here, again, we're in round two. We're getting ready for high bar.
Jake Dalton's going to start us off on the high bar.
Oh, yeah.
doing a laid out Tkachev.
Yep, and then he's going to connect that to a Tkachev with a half twist. So these are two release moves in a row, actually. These are going to be huge. He goes big. No hold, can't hold back. Laid out position. Oh! Wow.
Nice.
Now, we're going to have to see what the judges do with this on the replay, but he actually stopped, and I think you're supposed to connect them. But that was massive. He pulled a Tkachev with a half twist from basically no swing.
Right. Right. Like you said, they were supposed to be connected, and he started going the other way, recovered, and still managed to do the second release move.
Unbelievable. Jake Dalton, 2012 Olympian. And he is now training at the University of Oklahoma. He's keeping it okay here, too. All right.
See, he fell a little shy, went the other way, but still managed to pull through and for his second release move.
Unbelievable. And his grips are staying tight there. Luckily, he's banded them up. Sometimes those grips can slip out. He's got his X-bands on.
So, Chris...
We got Chris Brooks
Chris
here.
Will be next. He's preparing. He's kind of getting in the zone.
And remember, he's coming off that win from last round, so he's pretty happy.
He's probably feeling pretty good. You can see him as they're visualizing their skills before they go. What they want to do, what they want it to feel like.
Extraordinarily important. Chris Brooks, he just has fun out there. He's going to get on that bar. Watch that bar bend. I mean, Chris Brooks is one of the bigger male gymnasts here in the U.S. He just packs a punch. Watch that set. And boom. Wow. He went huge. Too big.
Too big.
Too high. Wow.
It was so high and just... barely missed it on the other side. He got his fingertips on there, but he wasn't able to hold on to the bar. I think he was just kind of, you know, had a little adrenaline, a little amped up.
All right, so here's the replay. Check this out. Big tap and throws that bar too hard. And look at that whole rigging. Got his fingertips on that. He's probably feeling a little burn in his fingertips when he's getting on the bar. His ego might be a little bit shot too, but he's going to recover. If there's one thing we know about Chris, he's resilient. He's come back from injury over injury, time after time.
Right. And the point goes to IGC.
Wow.
So Jake was able to use that mistake and turn it into a positive point for his team.
You got to capitalize whenever you have the chance. Especially in the skill-for-skill battle format. You never know what's going to happen. I mean, the gymnasts are out there trying to have the most fun, trying to throw huge skills.
Yes. And that's why it's different than an ordinary gymnastics competition. We're not doing full gymnastics routines.
And looks like we're gearing up for another interview. All right, let's go to a commercial break here, and we'll come back with some interviews.
Kindness works because I think it motivates people, and it promotes a positive energy, between whether it's athletes or coaches or anybody around them. I think kindness works much better than negativity.
I remember one year at a regional competition. I was younger. I fell off beam on our last event, and my coach came up to me after the meet. And the only thing she told me was, "You lost us the meet." And I was so upset from it. And my mom came up to me and was just like, "It's okay, you know, we're gonna compete next year." And what my mom said to me and being kind and positive just really helped me keep pushing myself. And I think that's what everybody needs. They just need support and positive attitudes from everyone.
Growing up, my career has had a lot of ups and downs, lots of injuries, lots of points in my career where I thought I was going to quit. I was ready to, you know, throw in the towel, and there was always someone there to pick me up, lift me up, whether it be a family member, a teammate, a coach. And so that's basically been, you know, the basis of my career is people being kind to me and giving me support. And recently I was given an opportunity to be on the other side of that. One of my really good friends, coaches, one of the strongest young women I know, she was battling a brain tumor, going through radiation, you know, had to shave her head. So I shaved my head with her to show her she wasn't alone. And just the look on her face when we finally got that picture together with both of us having our shaved heads was, you know, worth 10 times the amount of kindness that I got growing up.
Join us.
And make the pledge.
At countonkindness.com.
We brought the height. I mean, our skills were just much more on point than they were round one. We were really just lacking the energy, and so that's a difference maker in round two.
Great. So what do you guys think you need to bring to the table for round three?
Oh, man. I mean, the crowd is pumping us up. We just need to make sure that we're doing the same thing that we did round two, make sure we have a lot of amplitude, a lot of dynamic skills, and really just getting our energy up.
All right, well, good luck with the rest of the competition.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The last PGC event was amazing. We all had a blast, and I know the spectators had a really good time. And I got to watch the coverage at home with some family and some friends, and you know, we just went to a restaurant and sat down and had a meal and just hung out and, you know, just enjoyed it, because it's definitely a different view of gymnastics. And you know, PGC is more than, you know, entertaining the audience. It's showing that gymnastics is different. You know, gymnastics isn't this, you know, clean-cut sport with all these, you know, old-school regulations and rules and certain stipulations that people don't understand. Gymnastics is a high-flying, fun event that is exciting to watch. I think for all athletes, and not just gymnasts, but, you know, athletes all over the world doing any sport there is, you have to understand why you're doing what you're doing. You need to understand, this is the reason why I'm doing this process, and it's going to work because. And when you can answer that question for yourself, you live that life. You start to adapt all the things that that means to you, and you become a real athlete at that point. Well, nutrition is huge. I mean, we all know that, and I think that's an obvious thing, and you can't really debate that. It's definitely a really big thing. But for recovery, you know, staying healthy, and in our sport, it's really important to feel normal. You know, when you get into that competition day, I want to feel the way that I feel in the gym. Well, what did I eat before practice on Monday? How can I replicate that feeling to feel like that on Saturday when it's time to perform? So for us, nutrition is huge, you know, not only for performance and recovery, but at the same time, you know, our weight, you know, our stature at that point can make a huge difference. I mean, 2 pounds to us when we're holding up 8 strength skills and each strength skill is being held for 3 seconds, and it's the last event of the competition and we're fighting through and we need to get that stuck dismount in the last routine, that's when nutrition kicks in.
Welcome back. You know, I got a chance to talk to Brandon earlier, and you know, he just really said he enjoyed the fun aspect of PGC and just being able to be here with his teammates and throw big skills, and just there was no pressure. It was just fun, and they just really enjoy the camaraderie between one another.
Yeah, I mean, that really just exemplifies Brandon. He goes by hashtag winning, W-Y-N-N-I-N-G sometimes, so all his fans out there know him by that. He's also getting his master's in business and a certified nutritionist, which a lot of people don't know.
Yeah.
But here we go to his favorite event. Up first, though, Donnell Wittenberg. We're in round three here at the Pro Gym Cup. So Donnell actually on rings, people know him by this event, and he actually goes by Donzilla.
That's right.
Here he goes, and he's going, his sequence is going to be a back uprise inverted cross to what they call a slow roll down into an Azarian cross. So here we go. There's a back uprise into an inverted cross. He is upside down in an iron cross. He's going to slow roll it into an Azarian, right into an iron cross, and he takes a seat. Look at that.
This is easy. He's just relaxing.
He knows he makes it look good. That's too pretty.
Well done. Well
wow.
Done by Donzilla.
Donzilla. He's almost defying gravity up there.
So next up, it'll be Brandon. And hashtag winning.
Hashtag winning. And it was wonderful just to get a little bit into the psyche of this guy. Brandon, 2012 Olympian. Here we go. Let's check out Donnell. He's at the OTC now. He's the youngest of four. That's two sisters and one brother. And 2012 was a huge breakout year for Donzilla. He's second in the nation, only to Brandon Wynn.
Who's up next?
Here's Brandon. You can tell by the way Brandon swings rings and does his strength, this is a full-time job for him.
And it's full commitment. Like he was saying earlier, you know, it takes full commitment. Fitness, eating.
Got to get your head right.
That's right.
Teamwork makes the dream work. And here we go. There's Chris Brooks setting him up. Back up rise to inverted cross. Here we go. Now I'm going to call the skills out so you can follow along. Back up rise to inverted cross. Check it out. Let that stay in your memory because that is one heck of a hard skill to hold. Slow roll down. This is what they call the Azarian. And he pedaled. The man is pedaling through an Azarian into a cross.
He might take a little
cross.
Seat too.
Wow. You didn't think you were going to get some couch time out here, but my goodness.
They're just having all kinds of fun and making these skills look so easy.
Now, what are the judges going to do here? This is what's going to get interesting. The judges are having fun over there.
Oh, yeah.
Smiles on faces.
They're loving it. I think they're loving the entertainment, too, the little extra moves that they're throwing in there.
There's A.B. Grossfeld. There's Fred Orlovsky. There's Ivan Ivankov. Here we go.
See, and the judges are, you know, looking at these replays and trying to find the difference between the two. What stands out about one another?
This isn't your regular gravity up in here in this gym. That's not 9.82 meters per second squared. Apparently, we're in the anti-gravity chamber. And here we go.
And it's going to go to competitive nature.
Wow. All right.
They liked that pedaling. They must have.
You know, when Brandon speaks, he's straightforward, no backpedaling, but there is some pedaling here on rings, and it looks like we're going to the single rail.
So here on the single rail, we are going to have a full twisting double back dismount, and Oksana is going to start us off for Team IGC, and this dismount is two flips and a full twist simultaneously.
Almost like
she sets it up.
Boom.
Very nicely done.
And the crowd loves it.
To a great landing.
All right, and you know, this is a very difficult skill to execute as a dismount. Just like Oksana's last name. So for all of you right now in front of me, your laptops and your iPads, just all you want to do is say it now with me. Shusovitna.
Shusovitna.
There we go, and let's watch this replay. Shusovitna. Beautiful.
Very nice.
Oksana is a six-time Olympian. Do the math.
That's right.
She's doing these skills, again, before a lot of these PGC competitors were even born.
So we're going to have next, on the single rail, same skill, Catherine Grable. Full twisting double back. Catherine was a 2014 two-time NCAA champion. Huge year for her last year. She's just excited to be able to keep competing, but have fun with gymnastics. You know, she loves the competitive nature of it, but she said earlier that she just loves how much she can enjoy still doing the sport.
And here she goes.
Sets up her dismount. Good swings. Very nice, and just stumbles back a little bit, but other than that, great amplitude, just the landing.
She came, she conquered, she Arkansas.
Yes, she did. Very nicely done. At this point, it's in the judges' hands.
Let's watch that replay.
Really good start, right up in a handstand. She swings so well on the bars.
And
huge
powerful.
Dismount.
Power. Too much power.
Just stumbled right behind her. But that landing sometimes is hard because it's not a normal firm landing that she's, you know, they're used to, but
they've actually matted the foam pits here. Again, it just gives these gymnasts an opportunity to really strut their stuff, to show it off, swing a little bit bigger, swing harder, bend that rail.
Throw the big skills. That's what we want to see.
And it looks like Oksana takes the win here. And that's another win for Team IGC.
So at this point, we've got 3 points for Team IGC and 5 for Competitive Nature.
And here we go, Jake now. Jake Dalton. And he wants you to get loud for him.
He's pumping the crowd up.
Team IGC, he's doing this for the team. Here we go, Talk Half to Yamawaki to Ginger. Talk Half, update.
Nice. Very nice.
All right, and
to
Ginger.
Release move.
And that was a Talk Full, actually. Here we go. And we saw these guys warming it up. It was a little bit inconsistent. Jake holds no bars there. Talk folds it up all the way to handstand. Does the Yamawaki and boom, connects it with another release move.
Wow. The fans are on their feet. They certainly love that. I'd say he redeemed himself from that little mistake.
Here we go on the replay. Check it out. And he amps up the crowd. This must be his competitive nature. Here he goes. Starts it off with a nice giant swing. Does a half spin. That's called a blind change. And watch him set it up here. This is called a Talk with a full twist right there. Boom. Gets into the Yamawaki and a Ginger, which is a backflip, half twist, and catch. And he knows it. He knows.
He liked it.
Couldn't tell whether that was chalk or fire and smoke coming out of those hands, because he's got those hot hands. He's catching everything.
I mean, with a skill like that. Very nice. So Chris will go up next. You know, he's coming off of a fall. The last skill he did, he missed it. So he's going to have to redeem himself.
And he's our last competitor as well.
Here it is. There's a lot on the line here. There really is a lot of, he's fighting for a spot in the PGC event. He wants to end well.
Here he goes. Drops in the full. Gets the Yamawaki action. He shows it up. And he's up.
Wow.
And that is Chris Brooks showing everybody how it's done.
He's not done. He wants some more.
Oh! Folks, that was a triple pike. That's 3 flips in the air. Consecutive pike position. Chris Brooks rips off an imaginary shirt, picks up teammates.
He likes it. He's got Captain Grable in the air. That was awesome. That dismount, you didn't have to do that. That was just a little bonus.
Let's see the replay on this. All right, now count this out. Again, I'm going to take you right through this. He casts up to handstand. This is called a Talk Full. Dives in and a full twist out. Yamawaki right here throws that bar, catches an immediate backflip with a half twist called a Ginger. And then he still wants some action. He wants another bite. Hold on to your seats here. That's 3 in a row.
And he has the biggest smile on his face when he lands that dismount. And Competitive Nature takes the point, takes the win.
All right. All right, and that's going to wrap this up. Kindness, count on kindness here. That's one of the campaigns recently launched here at IGC, Count on Kindness. And this is just great seeing the team, the gymnasts get together. They're having a great time. Side hugs all around, high fives.
This is just nothing but fun for them.
But it also gets brutal because you know after the competition, they're going to be talking about who wins here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna see if we can take it to the floor soon. Well, this was an amazing, amazing competition, Ashley, and it happened so fast.
So fast, you know, and the skills they were throwing, it was really great to see just risky moves, really.
Big gymnastics tonight for all you folks. Not sure if you're used to watching the gymnastics. We're welcoming a lot of new gymnastics fans into the mix here. So.
With the one and only Chris Brooks. So Chris, how did that last round feel for you?
The last round was awesome. That combination I've struggled with in the past, I used to compete it, ended up taking it out of my routine because it wasn't consistent. So it felt amazing to nail it, last up, game on the line. especially that sequence.
That's great. How does it feel to be a part of this Pro Gymnastics Cup series?
It's really indescribable. This whole movement is amazing. I think it's good for gymnastics. I'm proud and honored to be a part of it. Can't thank IGC enough for putting this on. Just honored to be here.
Well, thank you for participating. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, now what we just saw, three events on each, two teams come together, and also we have some PGC athletes live chatting now, Steve the Legend Legendre, Jonathan Horton, Bree Olson, Alex Nador online on professionalgymnastics.com. It looks like they're wrapping everything up here.
That was not to love. That was a fun event.
Yep, absolutely, and this is, again, a new format for gymnastics. We got a crowd amped. And you know, bring it to the people, folks.
For all of you at home, we're so glad you joined us. Thanks for listening live.
Signing off from the Pro Gymnastics Cup here.
I'm Ashley.
And I'm Stephen Douglas.
Thank you.
This camp's amazing.
You can come here and get your workouts done and then just have the rest of the day to just enjoy yourself and play.
Just play, just have fun.
Coming to IGC is like a vacation.
Everything about this place is awesome.
You're doing the things that you love every day.
Every single day. We have everything here. We have laser tag, we have dune buggies.
There's swimming.
We've got space ball, jet skis, the beach area.
Scary area.
There's a zip line that goes across the lake.
And then we have the evening activities.
We do skits, cabin cheers.
Question and answer with Olympians.
What was it like competing in Beijing?
Do you know how to break dance?
We have karaoke.
And every week we have a dance.
The number one thing I like.
Staff exhibition where our staff puts on a show for the campers.
They do crazy stuff and it's insane to watch them.
We're just like,
wow.
Kindness works because I think it motivates people, and it promotes a positive energy, between whether it's athletes or coaches or anybody around them. I think kindness works much better than negativity.
I remember one year at a regional competition. I was younger. I fell off beam on our last event, and my coach came up to me after the meet, and the only thing she told me was, "You lost us the meet." And I was so upset from it, and my mom came up to me and was just like, "It's okay, you know, we're gonna compete next year." And what my mom said to me and being kind and positive just really helped me keep pushing myself. And I think that's what everybody needs. They just need support and positive attitudes from everyone.
Growing up, my career has had a lot of ups and downs, lots of injuries, lots of points in my career where I thought I was going to quit. I was ready to, you know, throw in the towel. And there was always someone there to pick me up, lift me up, whether it be a family member, a teammate, a coach. And so that's basically been, you know, the basis of my career is people being kind to me and giving me support. And recently I was given an opportunity to be on the other side of that. One of my really good friends, coaches, one of the strongest young women I know, she was battling a brain tumor, going through radiation, you know, had to shave her head. So I shaved my head with her to show her she wasn't alone. And just the look on her face when we finally got that picture together with both of us having our shaved heads was, you know, worth 10 times the amount of kindness that I got growing up.
Join us.
And make the pledge.
At countonkindness.com.
IGC started back in 1971. My father, Bruno, had a dream to create the best gymnastics camp in the world.
Bruno is definitely a legend in the sport of gymnastics. He not only was an NCAA champion, he was an NCAA championship coach.
Bruno's been inducted to every important group affiliated with gymnastics that even exists. You know, he's done it
it's
all.
It's been 38 years since he's been here.
38 years.
Yep.
He's just the godfather of gymnastics.
We're gonna have a good week?
Yeah.
All right.
My father pioneered the standard for foam pits. He invented the 6x6 foam block that's used in gyms worldwide. This helps gymnasts train and train safely every day.
It's gotta make you proud to make such a difference in their lives.
That's a pretty amazing thing to meet somebody who has cultivated such a community of gymnastics. I mean, when you step foot in this gym, you're stepping foot into a lot of history.
Bruno has passed that passion on to Brent, who's now the director.
Brent was a tremendous gymnast in his own right.
He was always the gymnast that I looked up to.
Brent was brought up here, just went down to the gym. That's all he did, just doing gymnastics.
I remember one moment from his national championships when he did front handspring double front and stuck it cold and got a 10-0.
Unbelievable. Just don't see that in gymnastics.
Give everybody a little bit of a special memory when they leave here.
He's life. He's gymnastics, yeah.
You know, and that's the thing is that it's family run, it's family owned, and the Klauses have just kept gymnastics running through their blood their entire lives.
They're family to me. They're just all good people. And they have dedication, devotion to gymnastics.